Top five answers on the board. Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
Sporting event.
Sporting event.
Strip club.
Strip club.
Steve, we're gonna play.
All right, great. Hey, Eva, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say a bar.
At the bar. Hello, Bria.
Hey.
Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
Maybe picking up some drugs, Steve.
Good answer.
I was picking up some drugs. I was... Tess, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
His side chick's house.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Over the side chick's house. Tony, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
I'm gonna say casino.
At the casino. Yeah. One answer left. We can clear the board, Kevin. Name a place a man has a good time till his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say over at his friend's house.
Over at his friend's house. That was a good answer. Two strikes. You gotta be careful now, Eva. David's family can steal, or you can clear the board. Name a place a man has a good time till his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say at work.
Okay.
At work. All right, family. Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
At a bachelor party.
At the bachelor party. Top four answers on the board. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties. Michelle.
Silk.
Silk. You better come on, Michelle. Michelle, congratulations. That's how you play relax. Chris, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
We'll go with cotton, Steve.
Man, I love you, Chris. Chris, you my man, boy. Oh, man. Got your dad down there?
Father-in-law.
He done a hell of a job, don't he?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Now, let me ask you a question here. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Lace, Steve.
Come on, boy. Lace! Crystal?
Crystal.
Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Polyester.
Now, let me tell something. I want to be clear. I don't know the rest of these answers. But cotton and polyester? Christian, If you give me this answer, we're still alive. We got two strikes, though. You gotta be careful. The other family can steal and win the game. Christian, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Spandex.
Spandex! Family, I got two answers. You give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the Smoke family is going to win the game. I need an answer. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
We're gonna go with latex.
Great answer.
This is for the win. Latex! Number four. I don't know. Well, let's go meet them, everybody. It's the Dowdy family. Yeah. Hold on one second.
Okay. Okay,
Steve.
Ooh. Hey. What's up, my brother?
What's
up, boy? Good. T.
Get the food, boy. For you, man. Get yeah. Word,
man. What's up? After the deal. Woo! Yeah. Woo! I've been friends with that dude for 61 years. Oh. Surprised me. Grew up next door to me. Been in Cleveland 61 years. Should've told me you was coming, man. I feel like crying seeing your punk ass. Top eight answers on the board, ladies. We asked 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed. Angela.
A police officer.
A police officer.
A dancer.
A dancer.
We're gonna play it, Steve.
Chuck, we ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A yoga instructor.
Yoga instructor. Hey, Mike, 100 women, an occupation a man has makes him good in bed.
Bodybuilder.
Yeah. Yeah.
A bodybuilder. Jen, we ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
No explanation with this one.
No, you just did it.
Okay, well then, he's got a pole, he's got a hose, a fireman!
He got a pole, he got a hose, fireman!
Yes!
Hey, Lori, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, so I think maybe because he knows about lady parts, a gynecologist?
Gynecologist. Cindy, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Construction worker.
A construction worker. Chuck, only one strike. You'll put a stop to that. Name an occupation that a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, Steve, what about a plumber?
This boy right here. This boy right here is just for my entertainment. I love you, dude.
Yes.
Plumber! I ain't mad at you. Mike, two strikes. The other family can steal. Give me an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A farmer.
Y'all messing with me now. You know, good with them hoes, you know what I'm saying?
That's where the saying came from, farmers are good in bed.
Farmer!
Come on!
Top 200 women name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
I'm gonna go with musician.
A musician, yeah. Number seven. Six. All right, now, guys, top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Joseph. Shopping.
Yeah, she is. Yeah. Shopping. L'Oreal, we asked 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
I would be doing the nasty with Steve.
I don't give a damn if that ain't up there. Best answer I've ever heard in 13 years. Do the nasty with Steve Harvey. Gemma? Mm-hmm. Talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Tuning in, watching Family Feud.
Tuning in. Tuning in, watching Family Feud. Miss Loria, talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
At the spa.
At the spa. That's a good answer. Now, Sterling, you gotta be careful. We got two strikes. The Sonya family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Traveling.
Traveling. Yeah. Traveling. Joseph, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful. Other family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Planning dinner.
Marjorie need to be at the house cooking me some damn dinner. We asked 100 women, you and Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Count my money.
Counting my Woo! Money. Send that to the house. Five.
Divorce in here.
Nah. Number three.
Sleeping.
Let's go meet the Wallace family. Hello, Edith.
Hello, Steve.
How are you, darling?
I am very well, thank
you. Good, good, good. Well, Edith, introduce everybody.
Well, Steve, I have my handsome veteran Army son, Jonathan.
Army strong.
Yeah.
My beautiful war veteran, Air Force daughter, Jeannie. My gorgeous and entrepreneurial niece, Candy. And down there, Steve, that's just Judy. She's my sister and your biggest fan. Hey, Steve!
Cheryl Underwood.
Hey,
Steve. As soon as I looked down there, I fell in love with you. I said, I'll be damned. That's my girl, Cheryl. Well, listen, I'm going to get to know y'all as the day goes along. enjoy yourself. Who came to win $20,000? Let's go. Give me Eric, give me Edith. All right, guys, we got top 8 answers on the board. Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him. Edith.
Photos.
Photos.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. All right, Jonathan. Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Food.
Okay, good answer. Good answer.
Food. Miss Janine, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Sex life.
His sex life.
Yes.
Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Clothes.
His clothes! Hey, Cheryl.
Oh, my goodness, Steve. You are funny, Steve.
What is my girl right here, man? I knew I loved when I turned the corner. I said, hey, welcome to the show. I said, I love her. I look right over there. Come on, Judy. Name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Oh.
We only got one strike. Edith, name something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
If they lived in the same house, she would leave him.
If they lived in the same house.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hey, Jonathan, something that if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Water, a water bottle, drink.
What?
Good water answer. Bottle.
A stained glass.
Good answer, good answer.
Water, you can't have. Stop giving her water. Oh. All right, Jeannie, we got two strikes. Got to be careful. Jorgensen family can steal. Name something if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Their money.
Oh. Their money.
Good answer.
Oh. That was a good answer. Name something if a guy shared it with his mom, his girlfriend would leave him.
Steve, we're gonna say a toothbrush.
Toothbrush! Top 7 answers on the board. Name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Beyonce.
You better know it. Greatest living performer today, Beyonce knows.
Cardi B.
Cardi B.
We're playing, Steve.
Beyonce's number 4. Wow. It's gonna be interesting. Michael, name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Diana Ross.
Diana Ross. She does, though. Michelle. Name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
J-Lo.
J-Lo! Name a female singer to bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey. Come on now, come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's think this out, man. Let's get some points on this board. We got two strikes, Dirt Family can steal. Mia look pretty confident. Female singer, bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande. Name a female singer who can bring the house down when she performs live.
We're gonna go with Shakira. Woo! Yeah.
Woo! Shakira. Number 7. That's a true statement. 6.
Rainbow McIntyre.
5.
Cher.
3.
Carrie Underwood.
Number 1.
I just love
it. Lady Gaga.
Top 4 answers on the board. Here we go. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Set.
Can I change it?
I like the way Lori said, set. Set.
Cut.
Cut.
Way to play, Steve.
Oh, I got you. All right, Danielle, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Action.
Action. Cindy, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
I'm going to say lights.
Lights. Alex, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Take one.
Take, take one. Michael, we got two strikes. If it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other team can steal and they get to play sudden death.
How about break?
Break!
Good answer. Yeah. Good answer.
I got two answers on the board, family. Here's the situation for you. If you give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family gets to play sudden death. Woo. But if it's not there, Morrison family flat out, they win the game.
Yeah.
So we need this one. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Quiet.
Good answer.
Quiet.
Quiet on the set. Number 4.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Dowdy Girls won the game. And now it's time to play.
Yeah.
All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
My mother-in-law.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Temperature.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
The seatbelt.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
5 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coca-Cola.
Name someone in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said mother-in-law. Survey said. Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank. You said temperature. Survey said. Name a safety device on a roller coaster. You said seatbelt. Survey said. What time does a gym rat work out in the morning? You said 5 a.m. Survey said. Name a brand of cola. You said Coca-Cola. Survey said.
Hi, Steve.
You nervous?
A little bit, but I'm gonna be okay.
I don't know how to tell you this.
Break it to me fast. Break it to me fast.
You don't like all this waiting
around?
No,
just don't even, just cut out.
You wanna hear about it?
Let me hear.
You need 2 points.
Oh,
Let me be a little bit clearer.
I'm sorry.
You need 2 damn points.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay. I forgot. What's I supposed to do?
2.
Okay.
You ready?
Ready.
Let's put that 198 points up on the board, all the answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Amy, name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
Husband.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Blood pressure.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
Seatbelt.
Try again.
Safety harness.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
Oh, 5 a.m.
Try again.
6 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coke.
Try again. I sure hope you get this 2 points. You need 2 points, $20,000. Somebody in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said. Survey said. Number one answer. All of them. Whatever she said, that was the number one answer. Answers on the board. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows. Carrie.
He lies.
Leo. Name something a cheating husband does the moment he realizes his wife knows.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Good answer.
Oh. Stop. Hey, man, we got one strike. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He cries.
Yeah. He cries. Tell me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He buys her something.
Come on. He buys her something. Big Nate, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Moves out.
I just caught you cheating. Moves out. Yeah.
Harry, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Maybe apologize.
Apologize. Going pretty good. Leo, wow. My man. Here we go. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He tells the truth about it.
Yeah.
You gotta just tell the truth sometimes, you know? And it set you free.
What's up there, Steve?
The truth will set you free.
He don't cheat, so he gotta tell the truth.
God, that don't even work in court, partner. Listen to me. There's a couple things you're gonna need to understand about cheating. Once you tell the lie, you must ride the lie all the way out. Tells truth about it. Oh. All right, we got two strikes. Salvo, we got to be careful. The Russell family can steal. Okay. Give me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
A divorce.
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 Divorce. Okay, family. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He goes and gets drunk.
He goes and gets drunk. Number seven. Four.